Joining me now in the coach's corner, as he does time to time throughout the year, including all sports season, is Bob Boyce, the assistant baseball coach at Davis High School. Bob, welcome back.
Thanks, Tim. Thanks for having me.
We're sick of the comfort of the shade here in the concession stand at Twite Field, because it's just a bit too warm to be sitting outside in the stands.
Oh, you know, it's summertime, and I wish we had this weather in the spring. I know that.
Yeah, I'm too bad we can't can it and break it out.
Exactly.
But let's do a couple things. Let's step back in time and review some of the things that happened in the Northeast Conference. We'll start with Davis baseball, then we'll move to the conference itself, the success of the conference, the number of teams that went to the state playoffs, including let's throw Cape Ann League in there as well, because a number of teams went.
Absolutely.
And then we'll move to the Davis Little League that just finished an incredible run through the state tournament. They lost in a heartbreaking fashion, and we'll get to that in a moment. But let's go back to recap Davis' this season.
Pretty good start to the season. We started out 8-0. Middle of the season, kind of struggled a little bit with throwing strikes. Obviously, we struggled with Beverly. They were the class of our league. Then we got in a tournament and played an absolute terrible five innings against a really good St. Mary's team. Came back from five runs down in the bottom of the seventh to tie it. Had bases loaded in the eighth, bases loaded in the ninth, and just couldn't get a hit. That was the story of our year. We only hit about 240 as a team. And with aluminum bats hitting 240 in the Northeast Conference, you're not going to win a lot of games and be successful at it.
But still, a 14-win season, as we were talking before we started the interview, is a season that a lot of teams would aspire to and go, hey, we had a good year.
Right, and as I told you, these kids were a victim of our success. We're used to the 19, the 20-win season, making deep runs in the tournament. But you know what? There's a lot of teams out there, like you said, that would take 14 wins, getting to the tournament every year. You know, and here's a newsflash. We just won our 17th league title in 20 years. That's a lot of teams would take one or two. We took 17 of them. That's pretty good for us.
Certainly is. Overall, the conference had a really good year. A number of teams went to the tournament. Of course, Beverly went to the state final.
You look at our league, and for years around the state, you hear the Northeast Conference isn't very strong. Isn't very strong. Let's look at the last 4 years. Northeast Conference had a team in the state final. Haven't won, but then again, 12 out of the last 13 years, the South has won the state title in Division 2. But you look at Salem, up-and-coming program, won two games in the state tournament. Swamps get played hard in the state tournament, had a chance to beat the D3 state champ against Austin, and they had one batting and lose by two runs. We did okay. Like I said, we lost in a heartbreaker to St. Mary's. Beverly, what they did was outstanding. You just had some good quality teams with really good quality kids. Really throwing it out there in the line in the tournament. That's what it's all about come that time of year.
What has been the key to success, the recent success of the conference, do you think, with so many teams playing well, teams getting better?
I think it's the quality of the coaches, to be honest with you, Timmy. You got Coach Wilbur over in Bellevue. He's fantastic, well-respected throughout the state. Coach Betancourt in Peabody always has really good, hard-playing teams. Obviously, we do okay with what we got over in Danvers. Swamps with Coach Kalishman did a great job the last 5 or 6 years. He'll be missed this year. You look at what Brian did up in Gloucester, another one that'll be missed this year. But that team's going to be a really strong team in the next couple of years. He did not leave the cupboards bare up there. They are loaded. I think just the quality of the coaches, and to be honest with you, the quality of the players. The kids are just outstanding. These are some really, really solid players. In years past, we've always had one kid go Division 2 or one kid go Division 3 or 4 or 5 kids total for the league. You look at our league this year, there's 25 or 30 kids going to play at the next level, and that's outstanding.
Okay. KPN also really excelled this year. You had a number of really, really good teams. It was really, really competitive.
Well, you had North Reading is always a powerhouse. They've been really good for seems like forever when Frank was there. Now those guys over there. Triton was really good this year again. How about Hamilton Wenham? Hamilton Wenham and Reggie did a great job over there. You got Linfield. They had the two big 1 and 2 stud pitchers who were outstanding. And then you got to look down the street. You got to look up 95. You got Masco. TJ always seems to have competitive, hard-nosed, well-coached teams that just know how to win, and they got talent all over the field. I'll tell you, North Shore baseball as a whole is very, very competitive, and we really get a pretty bad rap because we don't do a lot of the Little League state titles or the Babe Ruth state titles, but I'll tell you what, I'll take this area all day.
Well, let's move to the Little League state title. Davis just lost a heartbreaker as I was reading the game review in the Salem News last night. A last inning, bases loaded, two out, double, scored two runs, and they went down to defeat 4-3. Yeah. That had to be heartbreaking. Better to lose 5-0 as to lose in that fashion, because you knew you were that close.
Well, I can't speak for those kids. I know they were devastated, as most 11 and 12-year-olds are. We've had our share of that in Davis the last 3 years. We figured out a way to lose in extra innings, lose by getting blown out. So you never want to lose. You don't want to lose your last game. But what a great run for those kids. They really captured the hearts and imaginations of the town. Out there Sunday afternoon, had to be 3,000 Davis people, all in maroon and gold. And like Phil said in the paper, they lost in the 191st pitch of the Little League State Final. And to be honest with you, they didn't lose to a patsy. Pittsfield South was very, very good. But you talk about history repeating itself. 42 years ago, the 76 group lost to Pittsfield South in the state final on the last play of the game.
I'm sure there was no consolation to anybody who was around at that time. Went, hey, wait a minute, this is deja vu?
Yeah, none of that at all. But a lot of the 76 guys were out there hoping these kids could get over the hump. And to be honest with you, you talk to the coaches and you talk to the players, they never expected to get out of their district tournament. Because how can you? Yeah. You know, how can you? But, you know, their big three guys, Owen Gazanowski, Mike Maroney, and Stevie Reardon, really stepped up their play. And they brought the younger kids along. And it was a great run for those kids. They'll never forget it.
All right, I'm just going to pan out to show everybody where we are. We are at Twy Field, and it's really quiet out there, Bob.
Too quiet for my liking, Tim.
Because normally there's a Davis team playing, whether it's the high school or the Legion team. The Babe Ruth team plays here as well, and there are stands, and people are walking around, coming to the concession stand at all. Broadcasters getting hit off the head with foul ball. Speaking from experience, but there's always something here. In the background, I noticed there's a carnival being set up.
I think that's what's left of the carnival from during the Family Festival days when they had the little Fenway experience here.
Oh, okay.
But like tonight, the Champions Pub takes over down here for their playoffs against, I think they're playing one of your teams, Manchester Marlins.
Oh, ooh.
So they play 2 out of 3, and then they move on from there, but right now, it's the end of the summer for the Twy, so it's now rest and relaxation for everyone in town.
Do you know what I think you would know, but what is the town doing in terms of off season once this is start being used? Do they do anything with the grass or the field itself to keep it?
They'll aerate it. Let's see, fall ball starts September 9th, and it ends on the 21st of October. They come in on the 22nd. They'll aerate it. They'll spray it for bugs and weeds and what have you, and then they'll plan out their future for next year. I think next year they're looking to resod a bunch of the areas. It looks like in 2 years they're going to put a whole new field down, tear this one up altogether, and put a whole new field down.
Do you think they'll go turf?
Will probably not be turf based on cost.
Yeah.
You know, and you just look at it, and the big I thought they might, but then the horror stories about what happened and what's going to be the cost up at Newell, I think that put a kibosh on the whole deal.
Well, the field itself, I had a conversation with Brian LaFada today. The field itself has survived the winter. It survived two drownings,
right.
Literally.
Yes.
But the field itself is fine. It's the rest of the facility.
Yeah, the facility.
The stands and the slab it was put on.
Right.
Didn't fare
didn't
so
fare
well.
So well, no.
So long as you're not using concrete in the infield, I think you'd be all right.
If you've coached here enough and seen enough, our field is concrete when we play, and that's how we like it.
Yeah, but I mean, you get a lot truer hops. You know, when you drag it, it's hard, it's firm, it's not soft, the ball doesn't bury,
It's a big advantage to us to have a field that's rock hard.
Yeah.
Kids don't want to slide, they don't want to get in front of balls. We're our Davis kids. If you don't want to slide and get in front of balls, you come over and sit next to Roger and I. You know, we'll figure out a way to get guys in there who want to be tough and want to play the game.
Exactly. All right, Bob. I want to thank you for your time. As always, you're a great contributor to MSO, whether it's an in-season interview or during the MSO North Shore Sports Night. So we really appreciate your contributions.
Once again, Jim, thanks for having us. It's been a pleasure every time you guys give me a call. I love talking high school sports, and I hope I contributed something to someone that listens to your show. And if people aren't listening, they're getting cheated.
Well, thank you for that. And again, it's guys like you that constantly come on and share your insights. One last question I guess we have to ask. What about the Sox? 75 wins before the end of July.
I'd be very interested to see if they get Beltre back today. I heard Devers is going on the DL. I like the pickup of Kinsler, but a 38-year-old second baseman is a little bit tough, but they just don't have a really good, solid one right now. And they need another starting pitcher. They got another hour, about another 26 minutes to go, and then see what happens. But Sox are in pretty good shape right now, and as long as the Yankees are still beat up, that's all that counts.
You know, I don't think Devers is going to be out long term, and could getting Beltre kind of upset the balance of what this team has accomplished so far this year? He's another one, you know, on the tail end of his career. Certainly very talented. We know what he can do with the bat. He's still a solid infielder. You know, but Devers, they brought him up. They put him in the lineup for a reason.
Yep.
You're a young kid. You know, you can field. You're going to get better in the field. He's shaky times. Does he make errors? Everybody makes errors.
Right.
Okay. But he's got the potential. Do you set him back by bringing in a more experienced veteran, and now he becomes an occasional player where he's been a starter? And we saw this at shortstop.
Yep.
Where, you know, well, maybe we need to bring in Drew. Right. And we'll sit the other, no, and now you retire the other guy's growth, and you can't understand why he's not performing until you get rid of him and you put the kid back out there, which I've been a big proponent of for years. Bring these young kids up. You tell us they can play, play them.
It's just a double-edged sword. You're damned if you do, damned if you don't. You know, it's one of those things. Do you want to spend the money? Do you want to give up the draft picks? Do you want to give up the young players? Just remember one thing. The Sox have no minor league system at all. Hmm. They have depleted their system beyond belief. So what are you going to give away?
Well, that's the Dave Dombrowski way.
Right.
He's traded away the farm system.
Traded away the future for the now. So who knows? It's hard to look into the mind of someone who doesn't have one.
All right, Bob, on that, we're going to get out of here. Thanks again, my friend.
Thanks, Timmy.